What up, guys? Bobbo here, BrassReel Brothers. All right. In lieu of the Matrix coming out, we're about to do some crazy shit. All right, so here we go. We're doing The Matrix Awakens. So this came out, I saw this on my PlayStation the other day, and it said The Matrix Awakens Experience by Unreal Engine 5. And so I didn't know what that meant. I hadn't heard anything about it. So here we go. Let's check this out. It got released at midnight last night. It says enter. All right. So this is my first time doing a streaming game deal, guys. So here we go. We're doing this together. Oh, I just entered. Now, I knew that they were using the Unreal Engine 5 for the film. Like, it's the first time in film history they've done that and used the engine in filmmaking, if that makes sense. I don't know.
Searching.
And this is a free tech demo, so this should be okay.
Hi, I'm Thomas Anderson. Like many of you, I work with computers. I like the freedom I feel outside the limitations of the real world. But computers are also mirrors, reflecting back who and what we are and the choices we make, the worlds we build. They also confront us with questions about why we want to choose this over that. Why we want to make X instead of Y. Where do ideas of who we are and what we want even come from?
You take the red pill, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
Man, I hope this isn't just a rehash of the films and just a big advertisement.
What is real? How do you define real?
For instance, I'm not even sure why I'm here. I remember waking up and thinking that I'm supposed to come here. That it was important for me to ask people.
That's a fake Keanu.
What is real? Hi, I'm Keanu Reeves. Over 20 years ago, I first played the character Thomas Anderson in the Matrix trilogy. Those films pioneered digital cinema with shots like bullet time. Back then, we talked a lot about where the digital age might take cinema and narrative. In an industry where actors have tried to remain perpetually young, we wondered about digital faces that could become immortal.
Hi, I'm Carrie Ann Moss, and I played Trinity in the Matrix films. 20 years ago, we asked ourselves how long it would be before faces and bodies could be changed as easily as we change clothes.
We wondered, what would identity mean in a completely digital world?
And what would reality mean? When a world we can build feels as real as our own.
So I guess all of this is CG.
Oh, what just happened?
Yeah, this is what they wanted. They said they were fine with your theoretical.
Are done with the Unreal Engine 5.
Sexy action.
Which, if it is, it's pretty dope. You can still
marketing.
Kind of tell in their lips and stuff.
Marketing. I thought we were
you hear that marketing?
Total creative control.
Yeah. Welcome to the Matrix.
You still got it.
So their faces don't look quite like I thought it should.
Sometimes
you know, it's still you can tell it's CG'd, but everything else looks amazing.
The hell are you doing back there?
Sorry. I was told this is a sim preparing me to fight the system.
Right on. You know about this?
Yeah. It's all supposed to be a little.
So I thought this was supposed to be a game, but I guess it's just literally an experience. It did say experience.
But whatever you do, stay the hell away from marketing. See you soon.
Okay, he's flying.
So, what now?
Feels like it's in Matrix Reloaded or Revolutions.
Say no more.
Yeah, like that's straight out of the other movies.
Keep them off. You drive. I'll shoot.
Oh, so I am shooting. Okay, so now I'm playing.
Okay.
pretty sweet. I mean, it's like an arcade game, basically. It feels just like you were standing at an arcade machine.
Trinity? They're on the car. Boost the roof. My pleasure.
All you were controlling is the gun.
Sorry, boys. Of course they have a helicopter. We need cover. Hang on.
I mean, if they had the cinematics and the games looking this good, it'd be badass, because this almost looks real.
Still on us. Up ahead.
Yeah, it really feels just like an arcade game. Which is cool, I can have fun with that, especially for free, you know? And getting you all pumped up for the new movie. But I'm not really sure what it means by tech demo. Like, what is it demonstrating?
Come and get it.
That music. I wonder if that new music's going to be all up in the new movie too, you know? Because that trailer did have a little bit of a different vibe, but they got to have some of the new music in there. Or some of the old music. It's kind of like the new Dexter series, which I'm kind of disappointed with. But it doesn't really, it kind of has the old music in it, but not like I'd like it to. But this feels like it's straight out of Matrix Revolutions and Matrix Reloaded. Like, this doesn't feel like anything new at all. So that was just kind of a stereotypical move the joystick and then press a button. Like I said, this all looks cool and everything. It's fun, like for a little arcade game. All right, so if that's it, that's going to be disappointing. Because I had like waited a few days for that. It was like advertising the countdown till midnight last night. So I guess that's it. If credits come up. Because at first, like, Keanu was talking. Okay, let's see what this is. Or maybe it's just talking. Or maybe it's just starting. All right, cool. Says to toggle mass AI visualization. Okay, so what is this? Just like going around. Now I'm toggling day and night. It's just showing the city. And again, it's a tech demo, I guess. So it's maybe illustrating and demonstrating what this thing can do and operate as its own system, maybe. Just like kind of functioning as a live city on its own. Which I wonder if this means like the Unreal Engine 5 is saying that they're going to be using like cityscapes like this and everything, which, I mean, it kind of reminds me of Spider-Man 5 or Spider-Man and Miles Morales on the PlayStation as far as the city, but the city does look way better. No question. So yeah, now I see what this tech demo is now. It's showing you, I can toggle the rendered pixels. Now, am I going to get to move around? That'll be pretty cool. We'll see. All right. Nice. Let me see if it'll let me switch. I gotta change the... All right, sweet. I had to invert the vertical axis. Are you guys one of those? I'm goofy footed when it comes to the controllers on the right joystick. I press like I do like kind of like pilot. I press down to look up and up to look down. Oh, I can fly. Wait a minute. So it says to speed up. So this is me flying. I guess I'm just going over the city. How high, I wonder how high I could go. Now, if I just do this to walk, it goes back down. All right. So it's just demonstrating through the Matrix logo and through the Matrix IP and brand what this new Unreal Engine can do. But damn, look at this. The city looks pretty dope. Now, I will say this, this is on my PS5. It's definitely not at 60 frames per second right now. I wonder if I can change that. I'm checking right now if I can. No, that's just exposure. No, that's just... This is pretty sweet, though, because it's letting you see all the different things you can do. But it's definitely not at 60 frames per second, which is disappointing. I would have liked to have seen something like this on there at 60 frames per second. So see how you can mess with, like, all the exposure that can make it, like, brighter and all that stuff. So... this is definitely a demo for, that's what's deceiving about it. It's a demo that makes you think that, oh, this is going to be a cool little Matrix demo. And no, it's definitely an Unreal Engine 5 demo for sure. So I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to do right here. It's just showing me basically what the Unreal Engine does. Which is cool. You know, I appreciate that kind of stuff. But, like I said, it made it seem like it was going to be this just awesome, like, it was counting down the experience. So, other than that, I guess it's just letting me run around. I can't tell if there's, like, a mission or something I'm supposed to do. It just is letting me fly. And... walk, but even the flying is not flying. It's just putting you in a first person situation and raising the camera view, which is cool. But again, at this point, it's starting to look like this is kind of like the Spider-Man game, except I will say the windows and stuff look cooler. Let's see if we can see like some reflections in the window or something. That'd be cool. If not, then it's pretty much like the Spider-Man game. Yeah, no reflections. But it's still pretty dope. Okay, I see what you can do now. Oh, whoa. So essentially the Spider-Man game does this too, but... so I guess this is their map, and this is whatever city the Matrix is. I wonder how far around I can go. All right, so at this point, I'm just winging it, guys. This is kind of crazy, right? And it's a pretty big working city. I'd love it if they made like some sort of Matrix game like this. I mean, it'd be pretty cool. Right? But it's saying, you know, you're flying, but then as soon as I want to just go, it just brings me back down. Oh, yeah. All right, well... there's nothing really else to talk about this game. I mean, it looks cool, or this demo. It looks cool. It's definitely, I wish it was 60 frames per second. I don't really know how I would operate that, but we'll see. Anyways, there you go. That's the Matrix Unreal Engine demo, guys. Not near as exciting as I was wanting it to be, but I'm hoping the movie's way better. But anyways, I'm gonna get to work on my Krampus review. I'm working on that right now. And I'll put that out. So y'all have a good one, guys. Much love. And hit that subscribe button so you can make it to the top. See you soon.